Again, welcome back to this lecture. Today we are going to continue the rest of chapter 6, which was about the rate of return analysis. Now, the main idea in using this kind of analysis is by comparing, we don't know what is the prison world, what will be and what will be the annual world, but we know that there is a fact in our project, and this five facts, it help us to see whether we can do or continue within the project or not. And there will be another, another side, another investment side, or another offer for you to do your business there. Now, the main idea is to find the rate of, or to find the I star. And we say that we within I star is called the internal return rate. Means what is the, what will be the benefit of this project in terms of rate, interest rate. This is internally. And we have another computative, or let me say, another side that can help us or can give us the another offer, which is called the minimum, that the minimum attractive return rate. Now, the idea was to decide whether the project is justified or not. We will find this I star by from our cash flow diagram. By we say that we have two different ways to find that I star, which and which. Hello? And to find the I star, we say that we have two methods to use it. One is, so try to remember, one was the trial and error, right? Am I right?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
See? And what was the second one?
By the equations.
Equations. Okay, the equations will be here in the trial and error, right? So we will put the equation and we will try to solve that equation by trial and error, and then we'll be. But there is another one.
It's by Excel sheet.
Yes, Excel sheet. And the Excel sheet commands that we have two commands, right? Okay, try to remember. There was two commands. One is called
Right,
yeah, very good. And the other called IRR, internally return rate. So, and we said this is more common. Why? Because it will depend only on the sale values. And this is will be very important and very useful for us. While the rate, it should have a regular A, we should have this is a kind of limitation to use that rate. Then this was the whole thing that we have in the previous lecture. Now, we say that what if I have a multiple options, multiple, alternatives. Now, for that reason, what should we do? There is a procedure for that. And multiple alternatives here means more than one alternative should be there. Now, it means that we will have two options or three options. In each option, should we find the multiple I stars, for example, for A, I should find I star A, and for B, I should find I star B, and so on. Is that allowed for me? So specifically, no, we don't have to find for each of the alternatives their I star and then compare between them. Now, we have to find another I star, which is the difference between those two I stars. So we have, well, the idea is I have A, I have B, and I want to see which one is more suitable than the each other, than the other one. So for that one, I will try to have a difference in delta I star. In delta I star, I will compare that delta I star by minimum attractive return rate. Now that delta I star, it doesn't mean that I should have I star of A and I find the I star of B and I find the value. And this is not correct. So what I should do, I should do the following. The following is, we should have at least, this is called incremental, that incremental. I should follow the following procedures. Not that one. Okay. Let me start with this one. We have tabulated incremental cash flow diagram. So for example, if this was an option of A and this was option of B. So I want to check, find if which one is must be the best. Let me start with the one with the same, yeah. Now, which one should be the best one if I have this kind of two options? Now for A, we have minus 70,000. Let me do it in let me say this is, was an option that I want to see how much is the delta critical value, or I want to see in the delta I star. The delta I star definition is not to say we have I star of A and I star of B and to find the difference between them. Now we should, the procedure is to find that is to be first draw the cash flow diagram for A, which is here A. We have minus 70,000 and we have 0, 1, 2, and then 3. Now for this one we have $9,000 if each time, so we should, yeah, $9,000 each time we should pay it in per dollar per year. Now here's the one. Now the third one, we have the salvage value is, we have 5,000. Now this is, sorry, this is what we have for A. Now for B, we should follow the same thing. This is for A, this is for B. And we say that we have $90,000, 90. And we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So we have 6 years, and within the 6 years, we should pay the $7,000 and each year. Now, this is the 7, and then we have to also take $10,000 as a benefit. Now, how should I say, let me say, if it was given to me that the minimum attractive return rate for this option was 10%, select the best one. Now, the procedure is, firstly, we have to sort the both options. How to make that sort? I should say, first sorting. based on the p-value, the present value, the minimum from least to highest. Means what? Means we have an option that's A, we have an option that's B. So which one will come first? I have to write the first one and the second one. The first one will be A. Why? Because we have for A is 7,000. The second one will be the B, which is 90,000. So the sorting will be look like this. 7,000 is the first one, then the second one, and I will do the delta. The delta means that I will find the B minus A. So be careful, I will draw another cash flow diagram, for, not for A and not for B. Now I wanna find the cash flow diagram, generate the cash flow diagram for B minus A option. Now, but before that, we have a kind of a problem, a sort of problem, which is what? You can see we have here's N is equal to 3 and here's N equal to 6. So I cannot make, let me see, I cannot say B minus A directly and there is a deficiency in the year. So what should I do? I should find the LCM for A and B. What is the LCM? It's the least common multiple. What is the least common multiple for 3 and 6?
6.
It's 6. Now means 6 divided by 6, one copy, one cycle, and 6 by 3 is 2 cycles. So I should have another cycle for the for this A. Now still we have to do that. And there will be 4, 5, and then 6. Now there will be here's 5,000, and there will be here's 7,000, and there will be another 9,000, which is the same. Now we have two cash flow diagrams, the both are in the same year. So what I should do, I should deduct B, A from B. How to do that? It will be, look at the first one, so the cash flow diagram for A. Now look at the N, it's 0, it's 1, it's 2, it's 3, it's 4, it's 5, it's 6, we have 6 years. So in year 6, how much we have in A? We have amount of the that we have in A? Back to the cash flow diagram. In A, in the first year, which is we have minus $7,000, right? This is the 7,000. Now in year one, we have $9,000 minus 9 and minus 9. This is minus 9, all minus 9, minus 9, and minus 9, right? Now besides all that minus 9, we have in year three, plus 5 minus 7,000. So we should write that in year 3. So we should plus 5 minus 7. And in year 6, we have another plus 5,000. Okay, now just to make quite that this is as the this is what we have for A. So for A, we have in year 7, for A, we have in year 0, in the starting we have 7,000. This is the 7. And year 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, we have each of them $9,000 payment. While in year 3, we have another $7,000, which is here minus 7. And the other one, we have what? Plus 5,000, which is this one. So what I did, I just converted the data from cash flow diagram to a table. Is that easy? Is that clear? You have any question about that? Any problem? Just translating. I'm translating from a cash flow diagram to a table. Okay. Hello?
Sir, I think in year 0 we have 70,000, not 7,000.
I'm sorry, that's correct. Thank you for correcting me. I think, yeah, it's 70, not 7. Thank you. So 70, yeah, we have 70. We have 70. Now it means that also we have here 70, right?
And doctor, I think for B, it's 95,000, not 90,000.
Yeah, this is 95, right? I'm sorry. Yes. So this is 95. Now the idea is clear. Firstly, I have to compare between those two alternatives, A and B. So what should I do? I should try them and draw the cash flow diagram and see if there is a difference in the peers. I should solve that problem in the beginning. I should find the LCM, and then I should find the LCM. And then after that, I have to sort it from least cost to highest cost. So the least cost is that we have for A, we have 70,000, while for B, we have 95,000. Now, it means that this is will be for the first one. We have to do that. Now, I'm done with cash flow of A. I will go back to cash flow of B, and I will tabulate all the data that I have them in B. Now, I will start with the first year, which is 95,000, and then I will have only for the 6 years, I have how many years is that? I have the value of A is $7,000. We already have 7. We have another 7. We have another 7. And that's 3. Now I have another 7. Minus 7. And minus 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now in year 6, we have 10,000 plus 10,000. So this is will be plus 10,000. Salvage. Now I'm about to be between, yeah. So what I should do now, I should find B minus A cash flow diagram. So every data is here, should be deducted from here. Should be that. So the first value, it will be B, which is $95,000 minus $70,000. So what I should get is about?
Minus 25,000.
25, yeah, minus $25,000. Okay. The second one is we have $7,000 in minus, so minus 7 minus minus 9,000, which has become
2,000.
In the third year, I have 2,000 the same. Okay, and at the second year, first, second. The third year, I have to be careful. I have 9,000 plus negative plus 70, it will become minus 79. and minus 79,000, so it will be become, look at this one, minus, so we have minus 7,000, this is from B, minus all what we have here. All what we have here is minus 9 plus 5, okay, minus 70, which is make out
67,000.
Okay. It will become 60 in negative.
No, positive
67,000. No, okay, that will be in year 3. In year 4, it will be look like year 2 and 1. So we have again 2000, and we have years 2000. And lastly, I have this one. This one is we have minus 7,000 plus 10,000. Okay, minus what we have here. We have minus 9,000 plus 5,000, which becomes
7,000, positive 7,000.
Is it there? It's become positive 7,000. Now look. See, we have this new generated cash flow diagram. I want to see as a generated cash flow diagram, I can draw that one. So we have for the first year, we have a minus 25,000, and we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then 6. For the first year, I have 2,000 positive, and also I have 2,000 positive. Third year, we have 67, right? And we have positive 2. Positive 2, and the 6th year we have a positive 7,000. Am I right?
Yes.
Now, the question is what should I do with that? Why I did that? I want to see how much is the I star here. And it's called delta I star. Why delta? Because this cash flow diagram is a BO minus A cash flow diagram. So incremental, this is called incremental cash flow diagram. Now, this is the delta from B minus A. Now, I will follow the previous method for finding a delta I star. So either I will use rate, and here is rate is not working because there is no uniform A. So what should I do? I should use the IRR or draw an equation. Now I will go to solve that one. Sorry. I will go to open an Excel sheet file. Here's an Excel sheet file. And Here's the data that I have. And now the idea is to have this cash flow data. To do that, what I should do now, this is the cash flow diagram as you can see. I will go with the with this one. Now the year is 01, 01, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So now the idea is to how to find the the internal return rate is first to write tabulate in a cell values the values in that we have. So in zero, in the beginning we have how much? We have $25,000, right? Am I right? Hello?
Yes.
Okay, so for the first one, here's 25,000. And for the second one, how much I have?
2,000.
It's in positive. So it's 2,000. Again, we have 2,000. And we have 67,000. And we have another 2,000. And we have another 2,000. And finally, we have 7,000. Now, the I star, the incremental I star, equal. How to find the I star? I will use, we'll say this is equal to IRR. And the values that we have, we should use them is that. Those 1, 2, 3, so all 6 values. And you can see we have the highest is about 46%. Now the question is that what that means? If I have the minimum attractive return rate was, we say it's about 10%, right? Now, what I did, here's the steps again. I sort the A and B. So, and then I found the B minus A and cash flow diagram. And what did I did? Also, the third thing is I found the I star here for B minus A, and we call that I star as a delta. And what next? It's the time to decide. And we did that to know whether A is preferred or B, which one. So the question can be answered like this. If delta I star was greater than minimum attractive return rate, then A will be eliminated. A will be eliminated and B survived. What that means? It means we have to select B. It means that then B can be selected. What if the delta I star was less than the minimum attractive return rate, then we should select A and eliminate B. So So be careful. Here's the 2 points. Let's go back to the, yeah, so. This is was the how to do the cash flow diagram, and we did that one. So if that ISA was less than the minimum attractive return rate, it means that, oh, here's the, yeah, if the delta I star, which is here in our case was 46 point something, right, was greater than the 10, then eliminate A, B will be survived. So the higher cost will be, the higher present cost will be survived. If that delta I star was less than the minimum attractive return rate was, it means that in case if we get that as 8%, so in that time, then we will have A will be survived and B will be eliminated. Now, this is in case that we have more than one option, so one alternative. In general, we have two types of alternatives. Sometimes all the alternatives are giving you revenue. It means we have, in our case here, is there is no revenue, all are cost, there is no revenue, cost. But sometimes we are having all revenue. When we have all revenue alternatives, we should have, we should include an alternative and a third alternative, which is called do nothing. Here's the procedure. If we have revenue alternatives, and it will, you should have do nothing alternative. Do nothing alternative, it means that in our case we have A, we have B, so do nothing will be included, and do nothing values are all zero. So in our case, if it was the $70,000 payment here was, it was $95,000 here, is that. So the third one, which is I may include it, is the do nothing, so I should be zero. So when I want to compare between those three alternatives, I should start with both the first two ones. Then I will check which one will be survived, and the survived one will be compared with the next coming one. Now, based on that one, here's what we have, this example. Now, have a look on this example, sorry. Here's this example. Here's this example. They say that if we have Now, this is the other example. We have different alternatives, and it doesn't tell us that this is a cost, a revenue alternative. So we should take them as they are, A, B, C, A, B, C, D. So we have four alternatives, and we have the minimum attractive return rate for them. 35. The question is, which one it should be the best choice? We have the first cost for the A is 5, and B and C and D, but there will be for A, as we have an annual operation cost is more than, it's 3,500, why we have this values in the other alternatives. So the procedure is like this. And be careful that this moment, the very important thing is that we have all eight. So we don't need to have any LCM. Now, what I do, first I should sort them from least to highest. Now, it means that highest value of what? Of P. So $5,000 is the smallest contained, so A should be first one. And after A, we have 6,000 and 10,000, so I should take B and C and D. Now, this is the sort of the alternatives. Now, based on the what we have, I will take only the first two ones, and I will find the alternative, the delta incremental I star for them. I will find the delta I star of B minus A. Then I will compare between, and based on the result, if it was greater than minimum attractive return rate, there will be the compared, then I will eliminate B, A and B will be survived. And then that B will be compared with the C. And then if the delta I star of C, I will find C minus B. And then I will compare between minimum attractive return rate, and then if it was greater than, again, than the minimum, then I will eliminate B and C will be survived. And then the last thing I will do that between C and D, and I will find the minimum, the delta I star of D minus C. And I will compare between the minimum attractive return rate. And if it was look like this, so D will be selected. This is the procedure. In case that in the first one, this delta ISR B minus A was less than the minimum attractive return rate, so this has become A, and we will compare between A and C. Then I will find the delta ISR between C minus A, and then I will follow the same procedure. So to save the time, I will just do for the first two ones, and then I will, if you go and do it for the other ones. Just want to check, is the procedure clear to you?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, now what, now the sorting is good, right? The sorting for the alternatives are the correct way, right?
Yes.
Small, greater, greater, greatest. Now I will start with these two ones, so we don't need to do LCM. So this is A. This is B. Now the first goes, and I have B minus A. The first one, we have minus five, and we have, this is dollar. This is, will be minus $3,500 and dollars a year. And we have S, which is the salvage value. Speed, this is A, this is F, which is equal to $500,000. Now 500. The other one is 6,500, and in negative. And the other one we have $3,200 per year, and the other one is 900. Now because we have the same n, we don't need to draw the cash flow diagram directly for each of them. So I will just deduct that one from this one. So B minus A, it means minus $6,500 minus five. $1,000 will come with minus $1,500. Am I right?
Yes.
The second one we have B is $3,200 per year, and is so minus $3,200 per year minus. The other one is minus $3,500. So the result is?
Plus $300.
$300 a year. Remember, this is A. And S value, the value of S here is 900 minus $500. Now the result is, it's positive $400. Now, remember, this is a cash flow diagram. I can't find this one easily. How to do that? I'll just tabulate or can draw the cash flow diagram for this one. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, then 8. Now payment is 1,500 and the revenue is per year is 300. Plus 300 and the F is how much? It's 400. Now I can use the rate for this one. You can use, or I can use IR the same. I can use the rate because it's a regular cash flow diagram. There is no any interchange between interchange in the data. So I can say I will use the rate. Let me use to go to the Excel sheet. Here's the Excel sheet. So to use that one, let me say I will use the rate. So what should I use? The command is, let me say using rate. Okay, that will say, the I star or delta, I star will be equal to, this is called rate. I will say this cell is equal to rate. And then tab, how much is the number of periods in this one?
8 years.
8 years. And what is the payment in that? PMT means A. How much is that, A?
300.
Correct. Very good. And the PV is the present value, which is negative $5,500. And the future value is?
400.
400.
And comma, there will be zero. Now look at this one. I get this cell, which is, yeah. Now look at this one. The delta I star. Okay, the delta I star that I found that is between B minus A was 14.573%, which is less than, I think how much was that, which is, sorry, it was greater than. It was
13.5%.
Yeah, minimum attractive return rate was 13.5% per year. Now, since this BA was greater than 13.5%, now the decision is yours. See which one be selected, survived.
B.
So B will survive and A will be eliminated. Now means this is will go with us for the next step, and A will go and we'll go with the second one. Now go back to what we have here. Now based on that one, what we have here, so B satisfied with us. Now, next thing I have to go with B and C. B and C. Now we know that A was eliminated, right? A was eliminated. Now next step is for B and between B and C. So I should write B first and then C and then find C minus B. What is the B? P, it's minus 6,500. And what is the A or B? We have 3,000. And what will be the value of S of B? It's plus 900. Now, how much is the these values with relative rate to the C is 10,000. And there is a negative 3,000 and there will be positive 700. Now C minus B means, by the way, these are dollars, these are dollar per years, these are dollar. Now for C minus B is means $10,000 minus $6,500 means what? Means 300. 3,500, right? Am I right?
Yes.
Now the second one, oh, there is 320, sorry, this is 320. Now the second one is we have $3,000 massa, negative minus $3,200. So the result is $200 in positive. This is dollar a year. This is dollar. Now the third one, or the salvage value for C is 700. Now minus 900, so means it should have negative $200. Now I will take these three values, and as I told you, we have to draw that one. So this is will be for 8 years. 1, 2. Then 3, then 4, then 5, 6, 7, then 8. Now, how much is the P value for, this is the cash flow diagram for what? For C minus B. Now, minus 3,500, and there is an A value, which is positive 200. This is A, and we have an S. Look at this one. You have it, the S value is as a negative, so it is normal to have this value negative. Now, what should I do? I have to use the Excel sheet value for this one. And I can use the same rate. I can use also rate. So delta means delta I star, which is between C minus B, will be equal. Now I'm using this one, will be equal to how much? I will use the rate, as I told you, the rate. Now it's normal because we don't have any fluctuation or any things here. Now we have end period is 8, comma, the payment is, hello?
200.
What was 200, correct? And what is the P value?
Minus 3,500.
Very good. And the future value, now we have it in negative, so we should write it in 200 negative. And comma 0, then this will be 19,000, which is in negative. This is the Yeah, it is 18 in negative, which means what?
It means B survives.
Let's okay, very good. We have to. Now, this is less than the minimum attractive return rate, the 13.5, right? So means now means C will be, this is the C, so B will be what? Remember that here is the you have to be aware which one now, which one we are comparing between C, B, sorry, B, C, B minus C. So if the minimum attractive, if the delta I star was greater than the minimum attractive, the second will survive. If this is was less than the minimum attractive, the first will be survived. Now in our case, will means B survived again. Again, and C eliminated. Now, the second part of this competition tell us that yes, and the second thing that we have here. Now from these two ones, this is now cancel out B. So the next last competition will be become between B and D. Then the one that is competent. So now will be B, then will be D, then there will be D minus B, and you have to find the delta ISR between D minus B and to check whether it was greater or less than the minimum attractive return rate. And finally, you get the answer of this question, which one is the best choice? I hope it was clear. Any question, anything you need?
No, thank you, sir.
All clear?
Yes, sir, about the homework.
Yes.
Should we do the example, the last examples of chapter 5?